Hi, this is Phil from PDQ Merchant Enterprises and the ATM Mastermind Group page, and in today's video, we'll be talking about what five things I should bring to the bank to get a bank account. Always remember, here at PDQ and the ATM Mastermind Group page, we buy your freedom back one transaction at a time. We also have the free ATM Mastermind Group page that's free to join for like-minded individuals just like yourself who want to learn a little bit more about the ATM business and be in a like-minded community of other business ATM owners such as yourself. We also have the ATM A to Z book that teaches you from A to Z how to be successful in the ATM business. I took over 20 years of experience and I put it all in this little book. It's a nice sleek little book, see how sleek it is, and this could help for your ATM journey when you're just starting out in the game. It's a good little asset to have for you in your ATM journey. We also have, who want a little bit, learn a little bit more, take a deeper dive with coaching and videos, we have over 80 videos that teach you from A to Z how to be successful in the ATM business, along with agreements, vault cash agreements, mobile agreements, customer agreements, and all tips and tricks that I took over 20 years. We put it all in the course, and it takes a deeper dive into the ATM business. Everything and anything you could possibly run into in the ATM business, we put that in there. And we also teach you how to talk to your customer when you're out there talking to your customer about putting an ATM. Without further ado, the top five things you need to take to your bank to get yourself a business bank account. So number one, you're gonna need your corporation papers. Now, we go back and forth with this. I'm a big proponent of setting up a corporation and setting up an S-corp. A lot of people are talking about setting up an LLC. If you already did that, that's fine. Just make sure that at the end of the year, you file as an S-corp and save you a lot of taxes. But you're gonna have to take those corporation papers to the bank. Now, there's some people out there saying, well, Phil, can I get a business bank account just with a DBA? You know what? In this environment where it's tough to get a business bank account, you don't need any strikes against you. It is possible, but it's very unlikely. But I'm not saying it's not possible. It just makes things very hard when you're trying to set up a business bank account. I recommend, highly recommend, it's surefire way, works every time, is to have that corporation set up already so you can take those corporation papers to the bank, show the banker that you're a legitimate person and a legitimate business and that you're serious about your business endeavors. Point number two, you're gonna need a driver's license. So, state ID card would work, but they're also gonna wanna know who you are, where your business is located. Of course, that's on your corporation papers. Also, if you are starting out in the game, and you can get a business license with the state, that also helps to show your legitimacy in the business. The banks are really afraid right now of AML, which is anti-money laundering procedures. They have a whole book. They're looking at the ATM business. They're worried about people laundering money through ATMs, that they buy an ATM, they put it in their house, and you know what? The money just goes in their house and they're laundering money. So they're trying to avoid those. So that's one of the reasons why they're asking these questions and being very due diligent, and they're doing things like KYC, which is know your customer and where your customer is located and how they're doing it. So this brings us to point number three, and point number three is now the banks, when you're starting out now, they're asking for that processing agreement. We provide a processing agreement in the A to Z course, but you've got to have a processing agreement, or a lot of banks are starting to ask for this processing agreement that will get you in the door with the bank to open it up. So what's a processing agreement? A processing agreement is agreement between you, the ATM owner, and me, the ISO, that tells you that we're gonna move money from point A to point B, and this time lays out all the parameters of what we're gonna do and how we're gonna do it. The banks wanna see this paperwork because they wanna make sure that they're dealing with a legitimate business owner. And we've seen more and more banks ask for this. They don't ask every time, but it seems right now, I'd say it's about 6 out of 10 are asking for this, because they want to make sure they're dealing with legitimacy in business owners just like yourself. So keep in mind, they might ask for that. So if you sit down with the banker and they ask for that, you know what? You can always look to us. We can help you at PDQ Merchant Enterprise. We can help you with this endeavor. Point number four, they're going to probably ask you, okay, you're with who, such and such, what's their sponsor bank? A sponsor bank is the bank that sponsors us to move the money from through Visa, MasterCard, NYCE, Sears, Pulse, and they validate the transaction. So when a merchant comes in or a cardholder comes in your ATM, it runs through their bank, through the sponsor bank, which is Pueblo Bank & Trust, verifies it from Visa or whoever that the transaction is good, and releases the funds to your ATM to dispense the money. So they're the person on the backside of the deal that verifies the funds. They also vet us to make sure that we're a legitimate company. They audit us once a year. They come in and they audit us, make sure that everything is tip-top and in good working standard. But sometimes your bank will want to see that sponsor letter. So what I say is, here at PDQ, we offer that in our course too, to help you get a bank account through those practices and policies. And point number five is, the bank's going to say, well, okay, we see what you want to do here. What do you want? What can we do for you? Again, we're going to go with the three bank accounts. You're going to need a vault cash account, a surcharge account, a general checking account. Now, keep in mind, vault cash account, you're going to get that money back every day, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, and then the weekend money, Saturday and Sunday, coming again on Monday. So you're pretty much going to get seven deposits for vault cash. And then if you elect on your surcharge account, that's the second account, you need a surcharge account. That's the transaction fee that the cardholder pays. That may, most of the time it's $3, could be as low as $1, could be as high as $5, but somewhere in that neighborhood, somebody's paying what we call a surcharge. That money will go into your account, a different account. You want to separate those two into a different account, and that'll go in on a daily basis. If you elect, you could also elect to take it once a month. Most people don't do that, they take it daily, but you could elect that. And you're gonna get another 30 transactions, depending on the month, 30 transactions a month that'll go into your account. Now, your last checking account is your general checking account. That is just for writing checks, buying ATMs, buying other things, gas or whatever you wanna do, maybe you have a debit card. So those are your transactions. I hope those tips are helpful. Thank you guys for making this channel number one on YouTube in the ATM space. Please comment down below any videos that you would like us to make. And if you have any comments about this video or any other videos, put it down in below and we will answer your questions. We answer them all the time. So we're trying to make this channel amazing for everybody who's looking to get into ATM business. Don't forget to smash that like button, and we will see you over at the ATM Mastermind group page, which that page is growing and growing at leaps and bounds. So thank you very much. There's a lot of people with a lot of questions in there, and you know what? We're helping them through the process. It's a great community for like-minded individuals just like yourself. So thank you guys very much, and I'll see you guys over at the ATM Mastermind group page.